How many of you here are blessed?
Amen.
Amen. Are we all blessed?
Amen.
Can you say to the person on your right, I am blessed?
I am blessed.
Hallelujah. See, God is moving in the midst of us as we worship Him, as we praise Him. There is power as we worship God. And I do believe that as we worship Him, there is something happening inside of us that we do not understand, that we cannot understand things. But I believe it's God moving in. Amen. It's God doing something in our lives, doing surgery in our lives, inside of us. Amen. And that is why we are here, just to worship Him in spirit and in truth. Today, we will talk about a wonderful, a great message of God to us. It talks about a situation in the lives of this, in the life of this woman who has a big situation, a big problem. And I do believe that it happens to us. Sometimes our lives is up or down. But this is what she does, which we can learn from the Word of God. But before that, brothers and sisters, I would like to request everyone to bow their heads as we pray. Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, speak to your people. You are the one who gives message. You are the one who will speak to us. You are the one who will give, oh Lord God, signs, wonders, and miracles. You are the one, oh Lord God, who will anoint, oh Lord God, your people, oh Lord God, and you are the one who will anoint your Word, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Father, as you speak, oh Lord God, to your people, oh Lord God, may there be, oh Lord God, the power, oh God. May there be, oh Lord God, a revelation, oh Lord God, that comes from you in the name of Jesus. We are nothing, Lord. We are just an empty vessel. But fill us, oh God. Fill this empty vessel, oh God. That as we, oh Lord God, come unto you, Lord God, empty, Lord God, you will fill it, oh God, with personal anointing. Father, we thank you. We bless you. Jesus' name we pray, and all the saints of God will say, amen. 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 It's so good, brothers and sisters. We are not a programmatic church. Amen. We are coming and going to God with His Spirit. And this is the program of God. I don't know why, but it happens. But this is the program of God. This is what God wants us. It's not on our beyond, it's beyond our understanding, beyond our programs, beyond our activities. Because I believe that God is a sovereign God.
Amen.
Now, if you look at the story of this woman, it says, the wife of a man from the company of a prophet cried out to Elisha, your servant, my husband is dead, and you know that he revered the Lord. There is a big situation in her life. But who could just imagine your husband, who is the breadwinner of the family. At that time, ang mga babae hindi po nagtatrabaho. They just relied themselves to their husbands. And the husband, who happened to be a prophet, he is the one who in the Bible says na siya yung nagtago sa 50 prophets na hinahabol nila Jezebel. Siya yung sinasabi na prophet na yon. And he died. We don't know what happened, but dahil na marami siyang tinulungan, nagka-utang-utang siya. Nagkaroon siya ng malaking utang, and then said, your servant, my husband, is dead. And you know that he revered the Lord, but now his creditor is coming to take my two boys as his slaves. At that time, in Deuteronomy, na kung meron kang pinagkakautangan, at wala kang maibayad, ang pwede mong ibayad ay yung anak mo. At yung anak ko ang magiging alipin sa panahon na yon hanggang makarating siya ng 50 years old. And you could just imagine that woman thinking, hanggang 50 years old magiging alipin ang anak ko at hindi ko makikita. You could just imagine the burden of a mother. What can you hear our mothers? At ayaw ng nanay na mahamak ang kanyang anak. Sino rito ang nanay na gusto mapahamak ang kanyang anak? Wala. And even last week, pansinin mo, wala ang mga nanay. Bakit? Nagre-review sa mga anak. Parang sila yung mga nagpapaisa, sila yung nag-i-exam, hindi yung anak. Yung anak naglalaro, pero yung nanay nagre-review. Tama? Hello, mothers? Yung anak talagang laro ng laro, takbo ng takbo. Pero yung bata, ay, yung nanay talagang seryoso sa
ninyo, kabisado niya. Alam ko po yun, kasi si Sugar, ganun din. Nagsasalubong na ang kilay para tulungan na yung anak at yung bata naman. Wala rin kwenta, para lang lang. Pero pagdating naman sa exam, mataas naman ang iso. Amen? Kasi nga, no, ito yung gusto ng nanay. Ayaw na mapahamak ang anak. At gagawa ng paraan ang nanay, kumain lang yung bata. Gagawa ng paraan ang nanay, baka pag-tuition bilang yung anak. Tama? I remember when we were in college, napakahirap ko talaga dahil tatlo nga po kami magkakasunod pag-kuleyo. At dahil nga tatlo kami magkakasunod, nasabi ng tatay ko, baka isa sa inyo hindi makapag-aral. Imagine, baka isa sa inyo hindi makapag-aral. And I was graduating then sa engineering. Alam niyo naman sa engineering, napakaraming kailangan ng pera. Pera. So what I did is, nag-part-time ako ng draftsman para lang maipsan yung kakulangan namin. And it's true, God will do things. And even my nanay will do things also para yung pera namin, dahil sa Manila po kami nag-aaral, eh siya yung kahit wala niya silang kainin. Sabi nila, maraming gulay dito sa probinsya. Sa Manila, walang gulay. Amen? Kaya pag umuwi kami, para kaming mga posporo, palito, inulito kayo. Brother Robert, tayo ka, Brother Robert. Yan. Ganyan ang katawan ko doon. Amen? Ganyan ang katawan ko doon. But, alam nyo, ang nanay ko, ayaw na ayaw pahirapan ang mga anak. I hope nakaka-relate ang mga nanay dito. Amen? And then it says here, it says, but now his creditor is coming to take my two boys as his slaves. Kukunin nung creditor, nung pinagkakautangan nila yung bata para gawing alipin. At ayaw ng nanay, kasi pag naging alipin ang anak niya, for 50 years, hindi niya makikita yon. Kasi babalik lang yung bata after jubilee, after 50 years. Doon niya lang makikita yung anak niya, doon niya lang makakapiling yung maayos yung anak niya. By that time, matanda na rin siya. Baka hindi na nga niya abutin yung 50 years old ng anak niya. And so, she cried out. But this woman, napakagandang skularan. When she cried out not to someone. She cried out to the prophet who is the symbol of the word of God, of the presence of God. The prophet symbolizes God. And so, what she did is she cried out to the prophet. She cried out at that time, kilala mga prophet, they were the man of God. Amen? Kaya, pag may mga problema, ang mga kapatid, noong panahon na yun, they cried out to the prophet. They called the prophet. Kaya nga may mga prophets. Amen? But this woman, instead of going to someone and asking for money to pay for the creditor, she cried out to the prophet, the word of God, or even the symbol of God, or the man of God. In other words, she cried out to God. Amen? That when we have problems, this is a good example what to do in situations that we do not have money, where we have problems in life. And that is why this woman cried out to the prophet. And when she cried out to the prophet, she said, my husband is dead. Wala, yung nagbibigay sa amin ng sustento, patay na. Wala nang magbibigay sa amin ng sustento. And the only thing that she can do is to cry out. Cry out not to someone, but cry out to God. And when we cry out to God, there is something that God has something to do in our lives. And this is what God said. This is what the prophet said. He says, how can I help you? Tell me, what do you have in your house? What do you have in your house? A while ago, she said, I have a problem. And my problem is my creditor is coming to get my children. And that situation, she opted to call God. She opted to call the prophet. She opted to call to the man of God because she knew that only the man of God can do something miraculous things in his life. In her life, I should say. And so, she said, how can I help you? So a while ago she said she opted to the prophet, she opted to the word of God, she opted to the man of God, because it is only God who can do something miraculously in her life. And so in the next verse it says, how can I help me? You tell me, what do you have in your house? Nahihiya pa nga yung babae. Sabi niya, wala kami. Kasi naibenta na lahat ng upuan, lahat ng sala, lahat ng TV or whatever. Doon sa bahay niya, wala nang natira. Except, sabi niya, ano natira? A little oil. She informed what she had, a little oil. And you know, brothers and sisters, I just want to pause for a while of what is oil. Oil symbolizes the presence of God. Oil symbolizes many things. It symbolizes anointing. It symbolizes the power of God. Oil, in the early years, or even today, oil is very important. Pag wala kang oil, hindi ka makakapagprito. Tama ba? Pag wala kang oil, ano lang yun? Steam lang yun. Amen? Ang oil, napakahalaga sa panahon na yun. And they use oil also as one of their lamps. Dahil wala namang ilaw na ganito. No? Ang oil is used for beauty. Di ba ginagamit nila yung oil for beauty purposes? Tama ba? Mga beauty, tignan mo ang katabi mong babae kung beauty ba yan?
Amen.
Tignan mo na rin yung lalaki.
Amen.
Praise God. Amen.
Kumikin na
po. Oil has many use. And that woman, ikinahiya pa niya, sabi niya, I don't have anything at all at home. I don't have anything at all in my house. I don't have a chair, I do not have table, I do not have anything except little oil. And that little oil is very important for that prophet. When the prophet heard, what do you have in your house? It's a little oil. And what he said, the prophet says, as she informed what she had in her house, sabi niya, your servant has nothing there at all. She said, except a little oil. Diba? Can you just ilagay mo lang doon sa verse na yun, Brother Ox? Doon sa little oil na yun, anong version? We are in front of God is speaking right now. And I believe that He has something for us today. He says, Elisha replied, how can I help you? Tell me, what do you have in your house? Your servant has nothing there at all. She said, except little oil. Except little oil. And that oil is good enough, more than enough. Amen. For her to gain that miracle. Kapagyan mo sa second verse, brother. Verse 3. Elisha said, this is what Elisha said. Now, in the early preaches that I did, I titled this as, what do you have in your house? But God is telling me, the title of our message would be, the oil needs a vessel. The oil needs a vessel. Amen? Sabi mo sa atin mo, say to the person, the oil needs a vessel. Amen. A while ago, she opted to the prophet because she knew that only the prophet can change her life in favor of her. Amen. Only God can change our lives in favor of us. And then, when the prophet said, what do you have in your house? It's just a little oil. She informed what she had. It's just a little oil. And then says, the prophet says, go around and ask all your neighbors for empty jars. Don't ask for just a few. In other words, kung merong unlimited rice, seafood din na bakit? Kung merong unlimited rice, kumuha ka ng bucket unlimitedly. Kumuha ka ng vessel unlimitedly. And you could just imagine the situation of this woman. She was so pressured. Look at this. She was the wife of a dead husband who seemed to be known in that community. Kilala yung babae niya because she was the wife of the prophet. Amen? And look at this one. What the prophet told her is, go around and ask all your neighbors for Empty jars.
Wow.
Empty jars. Now look at this one. This woman who seemed to be so desperate.
You know, desperate people do desperate things.
Desperate people do not think of things what will other people say to them. Amen? Desperate people just do desperately. Amen? Look at this one. When she asked her neighbor, she knocked on the door and said, "Can I ask for an empty jar?" Maybe she's knocking at the door of Sister Marie. "Sister Marie, can I have empty jars?" And of course, Sister Marie would ask, why would you need an empty jar? Kasi lalagyan ko po ng langis doon sa katiting na langis ko. Ano sasabihin ng tao sa iyo? What would people would say? Yung asawa nung namatay na propeta, may tililing na. Amen? Saan mo? Anong ilalagay mo? Alam naman ng kapitbahay nila nung walang wala sila. Sasabihin nung kakatukan niya, anong gagawin mo sa ano yan? Tawag niya? Empty jar. Basyo. Basyo ng bote. Na basyo ba tawag doon? Empty jars. Basta empty jars. Empty vessels. Amen. Garapon. Amen. Sasabihin niya, lalagyan ko po nung langis. Saan galing yung langis? Doon sa langis ko na katiting. Katiting na nga lang, lalagay mo ba sa garapon? At hihingi ka pa ng maraming garapon. You could just imagine the pressure that she had. Amen? And so, she was so obedient. Look at it. Go around. Lahat ng kapitbahay niya, kinakatukan niya, hindi po ng basyo ng garapon. Amen? Nakukuha po ba? Sino hindi nakakakuha nito? Amen? Look at this one. Every house in that community, kinatok niya. Maaaring meron na siyang ganito na pinagay na niya lahat ng mga garapon na pinagkukuha na niya, hinihingi niya sa kapitbahay. And you could just imagine, yung kapitbahay nila, maaaring nag-uusap din yun. Tama? Nag-uusap sila kung yung asawa ng propetang namatay, kumuha sa akin ng 10 garapon. Sa akin nga, 15. Biro mo, yung 15 na yon, yung 20 na yon, yung maraming garapon na dala-dala niya, nalagyan niya ng oil doon sa katitin niya na langis. Imagine this. You could just imagine. Maaring tayo rin ganyan sa sitwasyon na yon. Marami tayong maririnig. But this woman was so obedient to the word of God. And when you are obedient to the word of God, and when you are desperate for a miracle in your life, no matter what they say, hallelujah, I am just obeying the word of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Now when you obey the word of God, something miraculous things happen. And so, as she went all to that place, to that neighborhood, asking for an empty vessel, asking for an empty jars, and then the prophet says, go to the next verse, sabi niya, then go inside and shut the door behind. Amen. Go outside. Go inside and shut the door behind you and your sons. Pour oil into all the jars, and as each is filled, put it to one side. Look at this. Inayos lahat ng garapon. Maaari yung dalawang anak niya, yung dalawang bata na kasama niya, bata pa, kuspos pa. Sabi niya, bakit at anong inasaan mo lalagay? Anong ilalagay mo dyan? At yung ilalagay mo yung oil natin na katiting na lang. Maaaring yung mga bata rin, nag-iisip, yung nanay ko hata parang bumibigay na. Tama? Pero ang sabi ng nanay, sabi ng salita ng Diyos, sabi ng propeta, go inside and shut the door behind you and your sons. Why? God doesn't want to show the miracle to the unbelievers. Because if you have the miracle with unbelievers, they have doubt. It might not happen. And so God said, the prophet said, go inside your house because they all believe that something miraculous things will happen on that night. Amen? And so what they did is they shut the door. Pangarin yung mga kapitbahay nila.
Their neighbors are looking of their activities.
Since they went to their house and get all the jars, empty jars,
tinitignan na sila kung ano susunod na gagawin ng nanay.
Baka pagpapabasagin lahat ang mga bote sa kanila. Baka kung ano gawin ng nanay.
They were thinking so weirdly.
These are unbelievers' mind.
But this woman just obeying what she heard.
She was obeying what God was telling her. And you could just imagine, as she closed that door, that those windows and everything, no one could see. No one could see the miracle except her and her two sons. And you could just, well, this woman was so desperate, as I've said, she will just do what God is telling her because of her situation. Desperate people do desperate things. And that is why when she had all these empty jars on the one side and have oil only on this little cup. Sabihin na natin nandito, ganito lang yung oil. And you could just imagine those empty jars lining in with that small amount of oil to be poured out into those numerous empty jars. And maybe even her sons were asking her, kaya bang makulong yan? Hello, brothers and sisters, kaya bang makulong yan? And so look at this one. As the mother starts to hold on to that little oil, she was like Moses. She was like Moses, sabi niya, son, the things that you have seen before will never be the same again as we do what God is telling us. The things that we have experienced before will never happen again because God is turning the situation in favor of us. God is turning all the situations, even you, even us. God can turn the situations in favor of you.
Amen.
No matter what, my brothers and sisters, though you have some experience with your healing or your sickness and diseases, though you have no financial support, but God can turn that situation in favor of you.
Amen.
Amen. And so, this is what happened. As she lined all these empty jars, this mother was telling to these two sons, son, you give me empty jar, and the other son, take all the jars with full oil on the other side. This is what the deliverance of the Lord will come right now.
Amen.
You will see things which you have never seen before.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And God is... Hallelujah. Can we give a clap of the Lord? Hallelujah. See, God is telling us today that no matter what situations you are, when you obey God, when you obey what God is telling you, God will do something. God will do miraculous things happening in your life. And look at this one. As she poured out that little oil into all those empty jars. Oh, hallelujah. Look at this, brothers and sisters. See, as long as there are empty jars, lagay. Can you imagine that one? Can you imagine that mother putting empty oil, putting empty jars, putting oil, little oil into that empty jars? Look at that situation where she was pouring out oil into that empty jars. And these boys who happen to be enjoying now, amen, the salvation, the presence of God in their lives. Look at this, as she poured out oil, that little oil into the jars, bote pa. Parang tagay pa. Bote pa. Amen? Lagay ng lagay. And look at this one, brothers and sisters. The oil ceases when there were no longer empty jars. The oil ceases when there were no longer empty vessels. This family had to pour. Wala nang mailagay, wala nang paglalagyan, pero yung oil nandun pa rin. Amen. Look at this one. The oil will never cease, but it's only the vessels that remains empty. Amen. That vessel is us. We are the vessels. And God wants to pour out her blessings. God wants to pour out signs, wonders, and miracles in you. But He needs an empty jar. Amen?
Amen.
That empty jar keeps on. Amen? Keeps on. She keeps on putting those empty jars with oil, with that little oil. And they see that maybe these two boys are enjoying. Then the other guy is lining up all those jars with oil. And the other one is giving oil. Wow, and that little oil, and that little oil. Without realizing, it came up from a little oil. Hallelujah. See, brothers and sisters, as I said, oil will never cease, but jars will be empty. Jars will be taken on, and we are the jars. We are the empty vessels that God wants to pour His Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is in us. The Holy Spirit is in you, but He needs an empty vessel to pour out new fresh anointing, to pour out new fresh healing. He pour out new blessing and breakthrough in your life. But He needs an empty jar. He needs an empty vessel to pour out the power of God in you. Amen. 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 And so they brought the jars to her, and she kept pouring. She kept pouring. And then look at this one in verse 6. In verse 6 it says, when all the jars were full, she said to her son, bring me another one. But he replied, there is not a jar left. Then the oil stopped flowing. Now what does God wants us? He says in His message here that oil will always flow in our lives. Yeah. It's always present in you. But it needs an empty vessel. It needs an empty vessel to pour out new pressure. It needs an empty vessel to pour out new healing, new power from God. And He needs an empty vessel like us. And the oil needs an empty vessel, brothers and sisters. And look at this one. And in verse 7, it says, I don't know, it's in verse 7. She went and told the man of God, and he said, go sell the oil and pay your debts. You and your sons can live on what is left. Amen? They saw how God moves in their life. As I've said, brothers and sisters, oil will be present, but it needs an empty vessel. Now today, brothers and sisters, as I pause for a while with this empty vessel, as I said, we are the empty vessel. God wants an empty vessel so that He can pour out His anointing. He can pour out His blessing. He can pour out new release of power, of miracles in you. But He needs an empty vessel. Brothers and sisters, it happened when God wanted to talk to His people. When God wanted to reach us, and what God needs is an empty vessel in the person of Mary. Mary was an empty vessel. And because she was an empty vessel, she was obeying the word of God. What happened is God has put the seed in her. God has put the favor in her because she was an empty vessel. And that oil that was put up to Mary bring forth the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And that empty vessel becomes a blessing for us for eternity. Amen? That's what God wants us, to be a blessing to other people. God wanted us to be an empty vessel so that we can be a blessing to other people. God will always bless us. God will give us situations in our lives. God will give you situations which you cannot comprehend. But when God gives you that situation, it is an opportunity for you to see the signs, wonders, and miracles of God growing in your life. Amen? God wanted you as an empty vessel. Brothers and sisters, as Mary obeyed God, she has the seed, and that is our Lord Jesus Christ. And that empty vessel where Mary had, what happened? She bore the salvation of God. She bore the hope of God to us. His name is Jesus. And because of that, Jesus lived as a man here. And he was Lord. Look at this one, brothers and sisters. An empty jar. Now, if you may ask me, I need a water. I cannot give you a water just splashing you. You need a cup. You need an empty jar. An empty jar is just how many cents? But it becomes special because without the cup, you cannot drink the water. How would you eat a pitcher? Okay? Where a waiter would hold on the pitcher, where the cheese are oozing into his hands. Do you like a pitcher with her bare hands? You might ask her, "Where is the box?" The box is just simple. The box is just maybe 10 pills, 20 pills. But it becomes important. That is what God made us. You are just nothing, but inside the box is a pizza which made it more delicious in us. Now look at this one, brothers and sisters. If you have an empty jar, and we know that the Holy Spirit is in us, we are just simple person. We are just empty. We are just a torn vessels. We can be torn by the devil. The devil can torn this one so that we can no longer worship God. The Holy Spirit is so powerful that the devil cannot touch the Holy Spirit. But the devil can do something to tore down the empty jars. The empty vessels. This is the thing that the devil wants us to tore down until we will no longer experience the power of God in us. But when you are in the power of God, knowing that the Holy Spirit is in us, the power of God is in us, amen? Though you are empty, God will make it more full. God will fill it with His anointing. God will fill you with His power, with His blessing, because you are the chosen people of God. Amen. Amen. And when God used this vessel, though we were torn, though we were trampled down, and as God wants us to be empty coming to Him, He will fill it again with new fresh anointing. And as that oil continues to pour out into that trampled jar or trampled box of pizza, God will continue to pour out His anointing. God will continue to pour out the blessing. God will continue to pour out the power of God in us until we become unbelievable. Saints facing God. Here on earth, we can be trampled by the devil. Here on earth, we can be pushed down. But as we keep coming empty to God, as we keep coming empty in the presence of God, He will always fill us. He will fill us with new fresh anointing. He will fill us with new blessing. He will fill us with new assignments. God is so powerful. That when we continue to obey, like these people, like this woman, you can just imagine, he says, go sell the oil and pay your debts, and you and your sons can live on what is left. Brothers and sisters, we are the empty jars. We are the jars. And God wants us to be empty and coming to Him, so that He can fill it with His new power, with His new anointing, with His new blessing in our lives. I don't know, brothers and sisters, what is your situation right now? You may be a good empty jar. You may be a trampled empty jar. But God wants you. God wants to make you new. God wants you to see the new anointing of God, the new fresh blessing of God in your life. And you just need an empty vessel to come into it.
as He pour out new favor into our lives. Mga kapatid, it's only God who can turn all our situations in favor of us. And the Bible says, when we set our minds on things above, God is so pleased. That when God is pleased and you come to Him empty vessels, when you come to Him empty as you are, God will fill it with new, fresh anointing, new blessing, new healing, new power, and new signs, wonders, and miracles which you haven't seen before, like these two sons. They never seen this power of God moving in their lives. But when you come in obedience to God, when you come empty into the presence of God, your lives will never be the same again. But you will see the power of God. And they other people will see the power of God moving in your lives. Brothers and sisters, as we stand and end up with this.